I am delighted to see so many faces with whom I have spent now days, months, and years, even years together. I would like to very briefly mention four things before you. Because if we are really talking about Kashmir, we need to have a reason to talk about it. And if you want to take the movement somewhere, so we need to have the strategy in order to do that. So the four things I would like to talk about is, what is the ground reality in Kashmir? Second thing is, what is the thinking on the streets of India? And third thing is, what is the international understanding? And the fourth thing is, what is our responsibility? What can we do in terms of all these three important factors? Because if the movement on the streets of Kashmir, I mean Indian occupied Kashmir, it is dead, you can't do anything. You may have all the senators of America, you may have all the members of Congress, all the British parliamentarians, they cannot do anything because the movement is dead. Now the question arises, is it dead? One of the most popular leaders, according to BJP, you know what is BJP?
Bharatiya
Janata Party. According to the senior most leader of BJP, the most popular leader in Kashmir is Saeed Ali Gilani. The person who mentioned it, his name is Ram Jethmalani, who was the Attorney General. It is not really Saeed Ali Gilani who is important. It is not Muhammad Yasin Malik who is important. It is not Nawaz Sharif who is important, because they are the leaders. To me, the person who is important for the movement is the man on the street. What is his thinking? Not yesterday, today. I am going to give you a few examples. I know it is being recorded, then you can check it on the Google or many other websites. India Abroad is an American newspaper of Indian Americans. It is being published from New York. India Abroad. The editor-in-chief is an Indian-American, he's a Christian by faith. India Abroad, in one of its dispatches, it has many dispatches, but in one of the dispatches, India Abroad writes, there were 1.5 million people. India Abroad. 1.5 million people on the streets of Srinagar. It's India Abroad. Ashok Jaitley was important, he just died a month ago. The reason he was important because he was the chief secretary of India in Kashmir. And he told me, I met with him in Brussels. I told him, I knew the chief secretary is very important. I asked him, what is chief secretary? Because he wanted to see with me and we met in the hotel in Brussels. What is this chief secretary? What is your job? Farooq Abdullah, you know Farooq Abdullah, he was the chief minister. He said if Farooq Abdullah has to have a cabinet meeting, and I will tell him that I am 5 minutes late, he cannot have the meeting unless I am there. So that is chief secretary. He told me, he said, Faisal, in one of the dispatches, which I as a chief secretary sent to New Delhi, it was, in Urdu, they called it Trari Sharif Chalo. Trari Sharif is a very big darga in Srinagar, Trari Sharif. Chari Sharif Chalo, us waqt wo ek nahra tha, let's all go to Trari Sharif. He said, I mentioned in that dispatch, as the chief secretary, there were more than 1 million people in that march. Gautam Navlaka is the editor of Economic and Political Media of India. He wrote that he happened to be in Srinagar. Us waqt bhi ek aisa hi tha, Mazari Shuhada Chalo. Unfortunately, we have applied to the new. It used to be an Eidgah. We used to have the Eid Salat there in Srinagar. Now it has become the Mazar-e Shuhada. More than 100,000 graves are there. Mazar-e Shuhada Chalo. Gautam Navaka, an Indian journalist, he said he happened to be in Srinagar that day. He said, it's a God's gift. I want to see what is going on, whether these Hurriyat leaders and anyone else, they have anybody to respond to. He wrote in the newspaper. He said, there were more than 1 million people in that procession. He said, what was really amazed, what was really surprising for me, I was looking into the pockets and the hands of the youth and women and whatnot. I could not find a single gun. It was all non-violent movement. So, dear brothers, when we are really talking about the ground reality is that India has really lost Kashmir. One of the most brutal governors within the past 67 years was Governor Jagmohan. He was looked not only for Kashmir, he was looked for the Muslims of India. Turkoman Gate, if you have heard the name, Turkoman Gate is in Delhi. It was 70% Muslims. He just bulldozed the whole thing as the governor of New Delhi. And he did the same thing in Kashmir. But he wrote in his own book, he wrote a book after he left Kashmir in 1993, that there was a time that we thought we have lost Kashmir, but our only worry was how to withdraw the army. It was true then, it is honestly true today. India really knows if there is going to be a referendum, if there is going to be an election, a fair election, there is no way that India is going to win in Kashmir. So that is a good truth about the ground reality, that it is live, not only that the leadership is there, but the people from all walks of life, they are with the movement. If anybody will tell you that the people of Kashmir, they are tired, wo to bahut thake hue hain, tell them on my behalf that you are telling a lie, because Gautam Navlaka, an Indian journalist, says there are more than 1 million people. By the way, the total population of Srinagar, according to the latest census, is 1.3 million. But this 1 million was not only from the Srinagar. They came from distant areas, distant villages, distant towns of the valley of Kashmir. Now what is the Indian thinking? I know that any Pakistani, or that matter Pakistani-American, they really believe in it. Ki unki rag rag mein Kashmir basa hua, you don't need to say it, we have seen it, we have witnessed it, we have seen the best of Pakistani people, we mean the people of Kashmir. We have honest, they have really proved to be the symbol of humanity, to be the symbol of generosity, to be the symbol of kindness for the people of Kashmir. I am not talking about money. Dr. Nazir is witness to it. I met Bilawal before I had this. You know, I was on a visit for 2 years. But before going there, Rizik Sam ne hai Allah ki kasam. I had a meeting with Bilawal. Wahan, Washington DC, mein he came with his auntie, Sanam, whatever he. So I had a meeting. I told him in that meeting, Mr. Bilawal, I know that you are a very important person for the people of Kashmir, because you are the chairman of Pakistan People's Party. But I am telling you, if you are giving any support to Kashmiri American Council, for that matter to any Kashmiri organization, stop it today. That is at least 2 years before I was arrested. Stop this today. But we, the people of Kashmir, cannot afford if you are going to stop the diplomatic and the political support of the people of Kashmir. That support we needed then, and that support we need today. But Pakistan is not really that important today, you know why? Because they already support it. I was, last time I was there in Pakistan, I met, you just name it, I met everybody. That was the first time I went in, even I went to 9-0, I was there, guess what, 3 days. MQM, I was there, guess what, 3 days. I met everybody. I met Nawaz Sharif Sahab, I met President Zardari, I met General Kiani, I met everybody. But to us, what is important is India. Now the question is, what is the Indian thinking here? I am not going